One of the common statement or a common phrase that we always hear is that when you design any water distribution network, make sure that major head losses or unit head loss value is always maintained to a minimal value as possible. But is this statement always true? The answer is no. This statement does not always hold true. And one of the key reasons is that when we design any water distribution network, we as design engineers, we need to make sure that the system that we are designing is always as stable and as balanced as possible. And one of the key tools that we can use to achieve that is accumulation of major head losses in our system. And shortly, I'm going to show you what I mean. Okay, so this is the software that I am using for this example. And as you can tell, this is WaterGems Connect Edition. Let me open this simple network. Okay, so let me open this simple network. You can tell we have this kind of dead end system. From here, we have a storage tank. And at this point here, we have a water tap, which is the end point, which by any chance, this is the point where the community will come and fetch water. If I run this model, for now, we don't have any issue, of course, in our network. But if I come around this area, if I activate, so for the pipe, if I activate flow, you can tell this is our design flow, which is 0.5 liters per second. And not just that, if I activate the diameter, you can tell this is the diameter value, which is, for our case, this is a 1.5 inch pipe with the internal diameter of 33.7. But remember, the value of the diameter that we are using here is the internal diameter of the pipe. And if you want to learn how to get the internal diameter of any pipe, link to that tutorial will be attached in the description below. Okay, so that was the diameter. And again, if I activate this head loss gradient or unit head loss, you can tell this is the value that we have. Of course, it depends on which design manual that you're using, but for my case, this is within the acceptable head loss range values. Okay, so if I go around this area, so for junctions, if I go around this area and I activate the pressure, you can tell at this end point, which as I told you, this is the water tap where people come and fetch water. For now, the value that we are having here is 34.3. Professionally, what we always aim at is to make sure that the pressure at this point, of course, at this end point, is always maintained within 6 meters of water columns all the way to 25. Of course, it depends on which design manual that you are using. But for my case, it's always within 6 meters of water columns all the way to 25. But as you can tell, for now, this value here, which is 34.3 meters of water columns, is well above the required maximum pressure. Now, the question is, what can we use to reduce this value? Okay, so that is the question. And we have two approaches that we can use. So number one is to make sure that we reallocate this water tap to some other places. But sometimes that is not possible. And the other option that we have, of course, as design engineers, is to make sure that we find a way to accumulate as more head losses as possible within our system. Of course, with one aim, to make sure that the dynamic pressure at this endpoint is within the acceptable value, which, as I told you, maximum of 24 meters of water columns. So the simplest way of accumulating major head losses in our network is by reducing our water pipe. So let me show you how we can achieve that. Okay, so what we need to do, let me go straight to a flex table. Let me go straight to flex table and select pipes. And what I need to do from here, as you can tell, for now, as I told you, we are using a 1.5 inch PVC pipe. This is not what I want. I need to reduce this pipe, of course, the end pipe. Let me take it from 1.5 inch all the way to, 40 millimeter pipe, which is the outside diameter. So the inside diameter of that pipe is around 34.9. Of course, that is the PN10. And let me run again this model and see what I have. You can tell for now we are having 31, which is again not that good. Let me go back straight to flex table. So from 34, let me take it to 1-inch pipe with the internal diameter of 27.1. Of course, if you want to learn how to get this internal diameter, as I told you, link will be in the description below. So let me take this down to this value, and let me close this and run again. Okay, so for now we have 17.9, which for my case is within the acceptable range. But if I go straight to unit head losses or head loss gradient, if I activate this, you can tell for now the value that we are having here is quite bigger compared to these values here. Of course, I can tell you this is outside the required value, but we did this intentionally to make sure that at the end point, of course, at the water tap, pressure is always maintained within acceptable pressure range, of course, dynamic pressure range, which for our case for now, as I told you, we have 17.9 and not 34.3, of course, the value that we had before. So this is exactly what I wanted to share with you today. And that is how we can use major head losses at our advantage to make sure that we have water distribution system that we want, of course, as designers. Until next time, I'll see you in the next tutorial.